Hello students, I am S. Kumar, your geography teacher. Dear students, in view of the sudden spread of coronavirus, our school is closed till March 30th. Therefore, we teachers are here to teach you some topics to save the valuable time. Please attend the videos and pen down the important points also. Students, we are using locally available resources for this task. These are our efforts and we hope you will ignore some mismanagement. It is truly said that something is better than doing nothing. Now students, the name of your geography book is Contemporary India. This book has total 7 chapters. Today I am taking lesson number 1, and that is resource and development. It has 14 topics, meaning today I am taking lesson number 1, that is resource and development, sansadhan va vikas. It has 14 topics. 1, meaning of resources. 2, concept of resources. 3, types of resources. 4, development of resources. 5, resource planning. 6, resource planning in India. 7, conservation of resources. 8, land resources. 9, land use pattern in India. 10, land degradation and conservation and their methods. Then soil as a resource. 12th, 13th, classification of soils, and 14th is soil erosion and soil conservation. Now, today we are taking the topic number 1, and that is meaning of resource. Sansadhan kya hai? I am giving you a very short definition of the resource, and that is, it is a source from which benefit is produced. It is a source from which benefit is produced. Take an example of coal. Coal is a substance from which energy is produced. So energy here is benefit. And the source is coal. So resource is a source from which benefit is produced. And benefit is energy. And that energy, you know very well, it is used for cooking the corn. Your geometry box has pencils. Aapki geometry box mein pencil to hogi hi na. Pencil is used to draw diagrams and pictures. And you know, pencils are made up of soft wood, and soft wood is obtained from jungles of Uttar Pradesh. Now your parents have cars, scooters, bikes, and you know, these vehicles run on petrol, gas. Petrol, gas are source of energy. These are obtained from mines located in Gujarat, Mumbai High and Assam, etc. Therefore, these petrols or gas are resources because we use them to run the vehicles. Your geometry box contains compass, metal scales, etc. These items are used in mathematical geometry. These items are made up of iron, and you know, iron is obtained from mines, and these mines are located in Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Karnataka, etc. Students, items or materials, pencils, compass, metals, scales, like items or materials like pencil, compass, metal scales, energy resources like petrol, gas are used by us to satisfy our needs. Therefore, these are known as resources. That is why it is truly said that resources is a source from which benefit is produced. Now let us give a more comprehensive definition of resource. Everything available in an environment which can be used to satisfy our need is known as resource. Har wo cheez, har wo vastu jo hamare aas paas paayi jaati hai aur hamari zaruraton ko pura karti hai, hamari needs ko pura karti hai, unhein hum sansadhan kehte hain. But three conditions should be there for a material or an item to become a resource. Now, what are these conditions? Now, I am mentioning here these conditions one by one. First, it should be technologically accessible. Means, we should have proper technology to develop or to utilize these resources. For example, a region has reserves of petrol or gas, and we have technology to extract it, then it will become a resource for us because technology is available for its development. And if technology is not there, next one is economically feasible. It means the resource found in a region should be cheaper and affordable. It must be economically available or accessible to each and every section of the society. For example, a big lake of fresh water has been found under the northern plains, but it is so deeper that its extraction needs huge amount of money, so it is not affordable. So we cannot call it as a resource. It is a reserve. It is not a resource because it is not economically feasible. Third one is culturally acceptable. Materials only becomes a resource when they are culturally acceptable. Culturally acceptable. Materials only becomes a resource when they are culturally acceptable. There should not be any objection related to traditions, ethics, value, language, or religion.